Okay, and then I am planning to show you that how I can open this Toyota car's steering wheel, where is this airbag, and what I need to do first when I am planning to like remove the steering wheel, or then if I am planning to remove the central airbag. And remember, this airbag remove is very dangerous job, because this can be make sound like bang, and it means that it explodes. Okay, but before, first step is to take battery minus cable away, and let's go to look at. Okay, and here we have this battery, and now first step is to take this minus cable away. Here is plus cable, minus cable is away, and then insert this minus cable in inside this something rubber, I think, like this my rubber glove, because there is risk that when we install our car, that this connector, minus connector, can accidentally hit in this minus cable, and then we have connection, and then there is risk that airbag explodes, and that's we insert that glove, this minus cable in inside this glove in that way, and then in hidden position, look, distance, and this rubber and this plastic, it insulates and eliminates electricity. Okay, and then we go back to inside. Okay, and then when I have first take this battery minus cables away, and now there is no any so big risk that this airbag explodes, then I can start to open these bolts and look in that area, in both sides. There is a hole in this area, and in here there is some cars, there is a plastic cover what we need to remove, but this is easy to find when we look that in Toyota logo, and in other side here there is this hole, and in that hole when we remove this rubber, there is, by the way, similar rubber in here, that area, in that position. Now we can see that in here. Then we can start to remove that. Now this wheel is in lock, and I need to open it. Okay, and now I open this key lock, that I can rotate that my steering wheel good, and then I need to take this cover out in here. And how it happens? There is the slot, and next I need that kind of tool, put this in here. And this is like specific tool, and I believe that this size is, there is 6 corners in that tool, and this tool name is Torx tool, and I believe that this length is something like 5 millimeter. This length in here, look, 5 millimeters. I can install that in here, that we can compare how big this is. Okay, and in here also we can compare that it is almost like this Toyota's logo's length in here, look. Okay, and that we need that kind of Torx tool, and we can find these tools in any auto hardware shop where sells tools. This is like Torx tool. And then my target is to install this my tool in inner of that hole, and look, it goes in only one. There is this head, it goes like in a little bit in that way. It is not normal way, because it is like a little bit in this curve. It is different angle in here, look. This is like central line, but now it is like in 45 Celsius degree. Okay, then I need to only rotate that in this direction. That way, look. And now it opens. And this bolt, it can be tight, but use high quality tools and force, and then this bolt opens. And then there is idea that, if I remember right, that I have to rotate that like 20 times, and then I can check that it is, now it's loose, look. I don't need to take this bolt totally out, only a little bit loosen. And then this another side in here, yes. There's similar bolt, and then I insert my tool in here, and look that it is not so easy to install. Okay, now it is there, look, it's really, really deep this difficult position, and then I try to open it, and opening direction is in that way, look. Okay, and in that way I open, and 20 turns, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, and 20. Now I believe I took that tool away. And then remember, in that part, take this really carefully in here. Because now there is risk that this airbag can explode. And then look, I am in a little bit away. And now I don't like to be in here if this hits in here. Look, that direction. And that's keep that area in free, because there is always risk that this can explode. And then, look, I will show you that what happens if this airbag explodes. And look my next video part, like info purpose. And then we can continue. And now, when I am opening this carefully, in that part, be very carefully, because now we can damage these airbag cables. Look, that yellow one and blue one. And that's in carefully, in we have to handle this central unit very carefully. Because those cables are so short, and in that way, this is good way to open, look. And now, I have to take first away this blue cable in here, in that one, this one. It is easy. And I only a little bit move that, and then pull out in that way. This is minus cable. And then, this is this airbag sensor. And it is good to open in that area, and inside in here, there is this hand grenade and this bomb what explodes in here. That's I move that a little bit in here, in this direction, and in same time I pull out. This is like first step in here, look. This is like security pin, and then I should to move that part away in here. And let's look at how it happens in here. And this is like first step in here. Okay, now it opens suddenly. Cool. And now I had small difficulties because I use my hand. Okay, but now airbag is free. Look, this is airbag sensor. Actually, this airbag unit. And then, do not ever open that, because it is like to open hand grenade, this army bomb. And there is this material. And then I remember, when we install that back, it should be always in that way. This way is this area. Now it can be in there. Okay, and then what we can see more. In that position, we have to open next this bolt. Okay, and then I need this socket what fits in this central bolt, and for that purpose I need this 19 1/9 millimeter socket what fits in here, and then I need also this longer bar that I can open, and then this bolt is quite tight, 50 newton meters force, and that's normally I need a little bit longer this opening tool, like in that one. Look, this is quite long, and then I install that in here, and then this opening direction is in that way. And then when I start to rotate that, normally this steering wheel moves, and that's in that position. I can take my key away and I lock this my steering wheel in that way, that I remove this one. Then a little movement, and then suddenly now it's locked. And in that position it is quite easy. Then I install my tool in here, and then I open. A little bit force, and then it opens. Okay, a note. And then it is so that I can rotate the central nut. And then remember, very important thing. Next we need this key, and I insert that in here. And I need to insert. Now it's my key in that position where I am planning to install back this my steering wheel. And now it's good to take in here some tape, duct tape markings, that we remember to install this our steering wheel in same position, because there is risk that we insert that in wrong position. Okay. And then, of course, and if you need to adjust that your steering wheel, like I am now planning to adjust, because now this my steering wheel is in little bit down direction when it should be in directly in central area, because now my car is going forward directly, and that's I need to next take this bolt out. There is this bolt, and this is specific Toyota's bolt. And then remember that normally we need in here this puller tool what pull out the steering wheel. There are two bolt areas and then this one bolt in here. But sometimes this, when we carefully move that, I can take this out maybe, and I am now very lucky. And now this, now I check that these cables, they are not any damage. There is not. But then I can open that part. Look, this blue connector in here. In that array I can remove that. But the idea is that when I take this steering wheel away, now it's away. Now I have to be carefully that I don't damage these cables. Look, and I can take those away. But now, and I like to only adjust this my steering wheel in the central position in that way. Now I insert it back. Now it's back, good. Everything is good, and then I can a little bit carefully check that this, and now I am pressing this wheel back. Okay, and then when we are installing this steering wheel back, it is good to move in both hands in here and press that inner that way that this bolt is so in same plane like in that aluminium ring here. And then when it is in same plane, I can take this bolt, and then this force what I need to install in here, it was this 50 kilonewtons, and I need next torque reference tool, and I will check that this my next I fasten and tie this bolt in 50 newton meter force. Okay, and then remember to fasten the central bolts to 50 newton meters, and also I recommend that you replace the central nut also, because it is really bad if our steering wheel opens when we are driving. Okay, and then this back installation and assembly is like reverse in other way, and there are those locking bolts loop in that area what keeps this central cover in here in this position. Okay, thank you.